Welcome to RBI. Now we are continuing with our fixed income. Earlier we have studied about the calculation of zero coupon bond and coupon bearing bond, means how to calculate the price of the bond. But now we are going to find out about the some definitions, okay, means some basic terminologies which we are going to use in our fixed income, okay. Basically our focus completely will be on the bonds, okay, means all the terminologies which we are going through will be related to the bonds. So now when I am talking about the bond, what will be the first point? I want you to write down these few basic points, okay, because all the points I have already discussed with you, explained it to you, but now I want you to write it down. The first point is the bond promises to make a series of interest payments in fixed amount. Again, promise to make a series of interest payments in fixed amount. So means what bond is giving to us? They are giving us interest in fixed amount, means the amount is fixed, okay, the amount is fixed. Second point, repay the principal amount at maturity. So these are the first two important point regarding the fixed income, that we are going to get the interest payment and we are going to get our principal amount at the maturity. Now third point, when interest rates rises, okay, in bracket you can write down the yield, the return which you need, if that require, we all know, if it will increase, the price of the bond, means the cost price will decrease. If the yield will increase, the price of the bond decrease, and vice versa. Now when yield are decreasing, why the price is decreasing? Because see, try to understand the mathematical logic also. If there is a 100 rupees I am going to get after 1 year, okay, if I am discounting this 100 by 7%, what will be the price? And if I am going to discount the 100 by say 12%, what will be the price? Okay, means what? If your discounting rate will increase, definitely the price of the bond will decrease. Okay, if the discounting rate, means the future value, the rate at which you are trying to discount it, that is decreasing. Clear? So now let us find out what will be the value. If I am using the 7%, the value is 93.46. But when I am discounting, then 100 divided by 1.12, it is coming 89.28. So when you are discounting by higher percentage, the value today will be lower. Clear? Or you can say when your required rate of return rises, you are going to purchase the bond at the lower price, so that your cost price of the bond will be lower as compared to the selling price. Then only you can make higher profit, and higher profit means higher required return, means higher yield. Clear? Now fourth point, we rate the bond. Okay, how we rate the bond? Suppose I'm just giving an example, there is a Reliance industry, there is a Google, okay, there is Facebook, there is Amazon. They all are issuing the bond, and suppose they are generating the yield of such and such percent. They are generating the yield of such and such percent. Now, if you will look this part, you will say that I am going to invest in Amazon because this bond is giving me higher amount of return. But you don't know the scene behind this interest rate. We all know higher the interest rate means higher the risk. Higher the interest rate means higher the risk. there are few companies which provide the credit rating. Okay, it can be your Standard & Poor, okay, Fitch, then we have a Credit Suisse. They provide us the credit rating. Moody's, okay. Now Moody said that the bond given by the Google is the investment grade bond. Okay, means what? Means you can invest in the bond and they are quite safe. But Moody said that the bond issued by the Amazon is a non-investment grade. Okay, means they are very risky and it is quite safe. So they have their ratings basically, and how they provide the rating, their best rating is this. Suppose if they are giving this rating to any bond, means what? That bond is really good. After that, they have this rating. Then this means this is considered to be the best. Clear? And after that, they have A1, A2, A3. So means this is how they provide rating to the bonds. And based on this rating, investor will take the decision whether they want to invest in the bonds or not. Clear? So there are three more, that is B, A1, A2. These all rating are considered to be the investment grade, and non-investment grade start from BA1, BA2, BA3, and dot dot dot, there are many till it will move to C. If they are providing this rating to any bond, it is considered to be the non-investment grade, means the bond is quite risky and C is the worst among all. These rating also give us the idea of the probability of default. Means if I am saying that bond is belonging to this category, means what? The probability of default of this bond is very, very, very low, and the probability of default for this bond is very, very high. Now, what is this probability of default? You are giving a loan to say B. Okay, you have given the loan of $10,000 to B. Now, you want to know what is the probability that B will default on his payment, means B will not repay the 10,000. So you said that there is 15% chances that B is not going to repay your amount. So this 15% chances is nothing but the probability of default. Now how I calculated this is completely now not being the part of our content, because now we are just into the beginning of our topic. Okay, but just for the idea of the hint, what is this probability of default? It means that what are the chances that B is going to default on his payment. Okay, it can also be 25%. If B is very risky, the probability of default will increase. If B is very safe, the probability of default will decrease. Clear? Higher the risk, higher the probability of default. Now, if you are an investor, and you will find there are two kinds of bond. One is with the lower probability of default and with the higher probability of default, and they are generating the yield of say 7%, and this is also generating the yield of 7%. So where you are going to invest your money? Sir, definitely I am going to invest my money in the lower probability of default, because sir, they are providing me the same amount of return. So why will I risk my amount by investing in higher probability of default for the same amount of return? But yes, if they are providing me the 17% yield, now I need to really think, because we all know that higher the risk, higher the return. So means what? For higher probability of default, and what is the meaning of why we got the higher probability of default? Because our credit rating is very low. higher probability of default, higher risk. Now investor want themselves to be compensated for taking this higher risk by getting the higher amount of return. Clear? This is the basic idea. So now, if the probability of default is increasing, the return is rising, means what? The price of the bond decreasing. Means again and again, I don't have to say, if your return, if your required rate of return is increasing, definitely your price will be decreasing. Why? Because you want your cost price to be lower. Then only you can earn the higher amount of return. So this is the basic point. Now, point number four, write it down. Now you understood the point that bonds are rated based on their probability of default. Bonds are rated based on their probability of default. Higher the probability of default, lower the credit quality. Higher the probability of default, lower the credit quality, and investor want higher yield. And investor want higher yield to compensate for the greater probability of default. And this leads to decrease in price of the bond. And this leads to decrease in the price of the bonds. Okay. We have completed the basic points. Now coming to the features of the fixed income securities. So basically, we are going to study the five basic features of the fixed income security. First of all, we are going to study about the issuer of the bond, means who can issue the bond. Okay, it's not me and you who can really issue the bond and which can be easily traded in the market. No, there are some specific issuer of the bond who can issue the bond. Next important point is about the maturity of the bond. Okay, means what is the maturity of the bond? Based on that, we take the decision whether to invest in the bond or not. Next, what is the par value? Okay, that par value is nothing but our principal value or the future value which we are going to get repaid at the end of the maturity. Next important point is, what is the coupon? And there are two things in the coupon. One is the rate of the coupon, and second is the frequency of the coupon. And the last point is the currency in which I am issuing my bond. So basically, these are the five features of the fixed income security. So when I'm starting with the issuer, there are basically five different kinds of issuer, those who are issuing the bonds. So first is the corporations. Okay, the companies, it can be financial companies or it can be non-financial companies. Like if I'll take the example, Google, Facebook, Amazon. Okay, then we have say Infosys, we have TCS. Okay, so there are many companies which can issue the bonds. But apart from this, these are the non-financial companies. Now what are the financial companies? It can include the banks, it can include the NBFCs. Okay, they issue the bonds. So these are the corporations which are issuing the bond. It can include the financial organization or it can also include the non-financial organization. Apart from this, the government will also issue the bond. Government of US, government of India, government of UK, okay, government of Japan. So they all issue the bonds. Now I am little bit giving you an example and explaining you that what is this treasury bond, because trust me, if you are just going through the book, there is just a single word, that is treasury bond. But if you are not understanding that word, it is not at all going to be helpful. If you'll find out the 100 students who have cleared their CFA, out of those 100 students, 70 students cannot clearly define you that what is treasury bond. Okay, so trust me, this is not the right way to complete the syllabus. So what I prefer is that along with the syllabus, we must be doing something extra which can like helpful to our knowledge, and when in the future when we'll go either for the job or anything, we must ensure that we have the basic knowledge regarding the topic. Just going only through the syllabus will not be helpful. So these treasury bonds are basically issued by the US federal government. Write it down. These are the bonds issued by the US federal government. US federal government. Now these treasury bonds are the part of the larger category of the US sovereign debt. Okay, now what is the sovereign debt? I will explain it to you later, but these are the part of the sovereign debt and we call them as the treasuries. We call them as the treasuries, and these bonds are risk free. These bonds are risk free, means if we are giving the money to the government, then trust me, it is free of any risk. Clear? Now their maturity usually ranges from 10 years to 30 years. Their maturity usually ranges from 10 years to 30 years, and they pay semi annual interest, or we can say the word coupon. They pay semi annual coupon or semi annual interest. Now there are basically the four different kinds of securities which the US government is issuing and are regarded as the risk free. They are regarded as the risk free. One is treasury bills, then we have treasury notes, then we have TIPS. Now write down the full form of TIPS: treasury inflation protected securities, and at the end we have the treasury bonds. We have treasury bills, we have treasury notes, we have TIPS, that is treasury inflation protected securities, and at the end we have the treasury bonds. So basically the US federal government is issuing the four different kind of securities, and the treasury bond is among the one. Treasury bond is among the one. Now the question arises, why the US government needs to issue these kind of the bonds? The reason is that they need to finance their spending activity, means government spending a lot. A US government, they are spending a lot for the citizens of the US. Okay, so for that they need money. Now how they will get the money? They will get the money through this bonds. Next important point is that our T bonds, that is the treasury bonds, they are actively traded in the secondary market, and you can purchase and sell your T bonds at any point of time. Now these bonds are not short term traded, means buying today and selling tomorrow. You must need to hold these bonds at least minimum for the 45 days. After holding this bond for this minimum time, you can easily sell your bonds in the secondary market, and their minimum denomination is $100, means you cannot say that I want to invest my $50 or $60. Their minimum denomination is $100. Sovereign debt is the basically the securities, the debt amount which is raised by the central government to finance the issuing country's growth and development. That is the sovereign debt, okay, which is basically the debt of the central government. Now we have seen our treasury bond that it is for 10 to 20 years or 10 to 30 years, but when I am saying about the treasury bills, they are basically the short term US government debt obligation, okay, and that is completely backed by the treasury department. But one is the most important basic difference between the treasury bond and the treasury bills is that they are short term, okay, and for less than वन ईयर, मीन्स देयर मेच्योरिटी इज लेस देन वन ईयर एंड दे आर सोल्ड इन द डिनोमिनेशन ऑफ $1,000, मीन्स यू कैन नॉट परचेज फॉर $500 or $600. क्लियर? सो योर ट्रेजरी बिल्स कैन हैव द मेच्योरिटी ऑफ से 4 weeks. ओके, आई एम नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द वीक्स. ओके, 4 weeks, इट कैन ऑल्सो द 8 weeks, यू कैन हैव 13 weeks, यू कैन हैव 26 weeks, और यू कैन हैव 52 weeks एज द मेच्योरिटी. नाउ हायर द ड्यूरेशन, हायर द मेच्योरिटी, द हायर द इंटरेस्ट रेट द ट्रेजरी बिल इज गोइंग टू पे यू. क्लियर? नाउ आवर ट्रेजरी बिल्स इज नॉट गोइंग टू पे अस एनी काइंड ऑफ कूपन्स. आवर ट्रेजरी बिल्स इज नॉट गोइंग टू पे अस एनी काइंड ऑफ कूपन. दे आर ट्रेडिंग एट डिस्काउंट, दे आर ट्रेडिंग एट डिस्काउंट, जस्ट लाइक आवर जीरो कूपन बॉन्ड. मीन्स वॉट? इफ आई एम इशूइंग, इफ आई एम इशूइंग अ बॉन्ड which is going to pay me $1,000 at the end of the year, I will be taking only $950 from you. This $50 is basically your earnings. Means today you have to pay $950 and after 1 year, I will give you $1,000. Now, you are earning this $50. Now, there are two different kind of tax system. One is the state and the local income tax. So, you are exempt, means you don't have to pay the interest on this $50. Clear? But there is a federal income tax and that you supposed to pay. Clear? Now, they have the maturity of less than 1 year, but the maturity of treasury note ranges from 1 year to 10 years. The maturity ranges from 1 year to 10 years. Clear? So they have the basic maturity of say 2 years, then 3 years, 5 years, 7 years and 10 years. Means I can purchase the bond which is going to like mature in 2 years, which can also mature in 3 years, or I can go for the bond which can mature in 7 years. Depends on the my needs and requirements. You are going to get semi-annual coupons on the treasury notes. Again, if I will talk about the taxation, the interest are not going to be taxed at the state or the municipal level, but yes, they are taxed at the federal level. Clear? Now, tips is very important. In what sense? Because there is one thing, that is the purchasing power. Means what? If today you are giving 950 and after 1 year you are getting say $1,000, but suppose you can buy one apple with $950 today, you can buy one apple with $950 today, but there is a very huge inflation in 1 year and now you are going to get $1,000. You did not buy the apple here. Now you want to buy the apple here. So now if you'll see, the price of the apple is this and you are going to receive only $1,000. So will you be able to buy the apple? No, because the inflation have increased very significantly and you are unable to buy the apple. So now what TIPS is doing, they are giving you a basic rate. Okay, they are giving you the basic rate of interest plus whatever the actual inflation will be in the market, that also they are giving you. Clear? So means what? If you are getting this $1,000, they are going to give you the additional $70 if you will purchase the TIPS. Why? Because they have promised to pay you whatever the inflation would have been. Clear? So they are going to give you the nominal rate of return. This is also going to give you the nominal rate of return. And this is also going to give you the nominal rate of return, which includes the inflation pre-decided. But TIPS is going to give you only the real return. And additionally, they will pay you the original inflation. Clear? Now, let us see that how the tips are going to work. Suppose today you are promised to pay 950 and say after 10 years you are going to get say $1,000, and along with that you are going to get the coupons. Okay, you are going to get the coupon payment. Suppose the coupon payment is 3%, but they have experienced the inflation of 10%. Now what they will do? They will straight away increase your future value, and your new future value will be 1100. Your new future value will be 1100, and we all know that our coupon is completely based on the future value or the face value. So how much coupon I am going to get? $33. And what is the future I am going to get? Future value is 1100. So you can see that there is a rise in coupon as well, because earlier the coupon was only $30, but because of this increase, my coupon increased to $33. Along with that, the $1100, the future value also increased to $1100. Tips is also going to give you the semi-annual coupon. Semi-annual coupon. So this is the one of the basic knowledge which I want to share with you, and trust me, this is going to very helpful if you are going throughout your syllabus, or if you are going to give any interview or your practical life. Because trust me, if you are not really understanding the market, you are nowhere. Okay, the competition is quite really high, so trust me, you have to be very thorough with your studies and knowledge and intellect. Even you have to focus more and more to learn something. Okay, so keep your eyes and ears open, and to grab whatever the knowledge is there, just grab it. Okay, now, so we have seen the corporations as well as we have seen the government are also issuing the bonds. Now we have in the third is the non-sovereign government. Now what is this non-sovereign government? These are basically the states, the municipal organizations. Okay, they are raising the money with the help of the bonds. Okay, now what's their motto to raise the money? They want to build the schools, buildings, highways, roads, okay, canals. So they have lots of things to do, and in order to do all these tasks, they need the money. Now the municipal government simply issue the bonds, and they can raise the money with the help of bond. Now they collect lots of tax from the people. With the help of this tax, they will repay the interest along with the principals. Clear? Next, point number 4 is the quasi-government entities. Fourth is the quasi-government entities. Write it down, quasi, Q-U-A-S-I, quasi-government entities. Okay, these are the basically the government entity, but not directly controlled by the central government. These are the government's entity, but they are not directly controlled by the central government. Okay, such as the SEBI. If I'll talk from the India's point of view, SEBI is the example. Okay, it basically includes the boards, okay, which are the government entities but not directly controlled by the central government. That's why they are the quasi government entity. Now if SEBI needs some money, what they will do? They will issue the bonds in the market, and they will do all the things they need to do. Clear? There is one more entity, that is the Federal National Mortgage Association. These are basically the association which are controlling the issuance of the mortgage. Okay, so I want you to study about it so that you will be having a lots and lots of knowledge. And the next is the supranational entities. Supranational entities. Now, what is this supranational entities? These are the organization which operates at the global level, such as the World Bank, Now, if the World Bank needs money, they can also issue the bond. Now, World Bank is coming under the category of supranational entities. Okay, IMF also is a part of this. Okay, European Investment Bank is the part of this supranational entities. Apart from this also, there are many organization. Okay, I will take only the name of the organization which you are aware of. Okay, that is the World Health Organization is the part of this supranational. Now, International Accounting Standard Board, that is IASB. They are also the part of this our supranational organization or entities. Now, we have the Asian Development Bank. Asian Development Bank. They are also the part of this. Then, I have already discussed regarding the International Monetary Fund, that is IMF. Now, United Nation is also United Nation, UN. United Nation is also the part of this. Then, Chief Actuaries Forum. Chief Actuaries Forum, that is CAF, is also the part of this supranational entity. Clear? Apart from this, there are many. Okay. So, we have studied a lot in detail regarding the issuer. Okay. In the next session, we will cover up the other topics. Thank you.